For the first time in 5 years, downtown Jacksonville is abuzz in anticipation of a Jaguars playoff game, and a raucous crowd of 70,000 settles in as the Jaguars take the field. It'll be a battle of next-gen quarterbacks as Trevor Lawrence and the Jaguars face Justin Herbert and the Los Angeles Chargers in this AFC wildcard playoff game. Al Michaels along with Tony Dungy. Fancy meeting you here.
I can't believe it. After all these games that you called of mine, I'm sitting next to you.
We'll have some fun tonight. The Chargers were 6-6, got hot down the stretch. Here they are. They're trying to get to a Super Bowl for the first time in 28 years. But first things first, what will they have to do tonight against the Jaguars to ensure a game next weekend?
Well, you mentioned the quarterbacks. Justin Herbert, their quarterback, is special. He can make every throw. He doesn't have his big play receiver, Mike Williams, but he spreads the ball around. He's going against the 28th ranked pass defense of the Jaguars. Their task, the Chargers, is to keep him upright and protect him so he can work.
Jaguars were 4-29, terrible, over 2 years. They brought Doug Peterson in. He's changed the culture. He's changed everything. They win a division title. What will the Jaguars have to do now to make sure it's not one and done?
Well, they've got a great quarterback, too, in Trevor Lawrence, but I don't think that's going to be the game plan tonight. These Jaguars think they can win the game in the trenches. They can pound them with Travis Etienne, their great running back. I expect to see a physical game tonight going after the Chargers.
It's the playoffs. It's high drama. What's not to love?
Jaguars, too. Yes, how about this? No.
Jaguars Chargers next on NBC.
NBC's Wild Card Playoff is brought to you by GEICO. Save even more when you bundle home and car insurance. And by Hyundai. It's your journey. NBC Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the National Football League.
The anticipation for this one has just been through the roof.
They say the first time is always the best. And come on, when you've spent your whole life dreaming about it, when you've dedicated years and years to it.
And Clemson celebrates.
Jaguars select Trevor Lawrence.
When you've played for it, fought for it, earned it.
Justin Herbert has scored!
There's nothing better in the world. Drop the hype. Forget the hair. These two belong here. And tonight feels like just the start of the story.
Trevor Lawrence has been ridiculous today.
Unreal. What a throw by Justin Herbert.
They've got the biggest job in sports, the greatest expectations, the highest degree of difficulty.
How about that crazy play?
Exactly the shot they want. They're on this stage for the first time, and they're definitely not dreaming anymore. Welcome to Wild Card Saturday Night.
And welcome to Super Wild Card Weekend presented by Verizon. To the field we go. Check in with Kaylee Hartung. Kaylee.
Hey there, Al. As Tony mentioned, the Chargers made the trip to Jacksonville without their star receiver, Mike Williams. In last week's game, he injured his back, and further tests just yesterday revealed a small fracture of a vertebra in his lower spine. Now, Justin Herbert called Williams one of the very best players in the NFL and a generational talent. But this Chargers offense has had to piece it together through key injuries all year. They are the only team in the league with six players over 500 yards receiving, and they have been led by running back Austin Eckler. Eckler told me the only thing he focuses on is being consistent in the role he's put in. This year, that has meant catching more balls than usual, all the way to a franchise record 107. And even though he has scored more touchdowns than anyone in the NFL over the past two seasons, Eckler told me the guys whose names you know, the ones who leave a legacy, they're the ones who get it done in the playoffs. Now,
thank you, Kaylee. Take a look at the coaches. Brandon Staley is in his second season as the head coach with the Chargers. Doug Peterson, 5 years in Philadelphia. In year two, he won the Super Bowl against New England. Took last year off and then gets hired by the Jaguars. Chargers won the toss. They have deferred. That's Cameron Dicker, who's really cleaned up the Charger kicking problems this season. He's been great. And dropping back is Jamal Agnew, who's a dangerous returner.
And this atmosphere, Al, is something special.
You could tell that last week, too, against Tennessee. And what was, in effect, a wild card game. It was a win and get in. Agnew from the 3-yard line.